uma perua laranja imunda ano 93? Ou será que é? Quem são esses guerreiros destemidos?
Nós somos os Mitchells, as únicas pessoas que podem salvar o mundo. Foi mauzão aí, galera.
For my first question, I would like to ask, for how long have you been working on this movie?
6 years.
years off.
Well, I mean, we worked on it about 5, and then we wrapped up in December. But it was a really long journey in making the film, because these movies take a long time, and also we had a long process.
And did it change a lot since the first idea you had until this?
It did. Like, one of the ideas that I was like really excited about is I was like, the family's gonna kidnap the president. It's gonna be the funniest scene in the world. It's gonna be great. And my co-writer was always like, why are they kidnapping the president? I was like, no, it's going to be hilarious. And then, like, we showed the screening and the kidnapping the president. People were like, what is this? And then, so we cut it. But, okay. So we had a lot of different iterations, but it was always kind of the same basic structure. It was sort of like we've just over the years kind of made it better.
There are two things that I wish to know if they were there from the beginning. Different art styles clashing with each other. That was super cool. And also the pacing of the movie is really, really fast, and things happen one on top of the other. So was it like that from the beginning?
I think the art style was not there from the beginning. It was the only thing that we had for the art style was a checkbox on the wall that said, make it look amazing and unique. And we're like, all right, how are we gonna check that checkbox? But luckily, we had an awesome team of artists who sort of like, we were all really hands in, is me and Lindsay Olivares, our production designer, and so many of the great artists on our team were like, put our hands in, we're like, we want it to look different. You know, it's a movie about humans, so we want to make it feel like every frame is drawn by a human and stuff. And then in terms of the collage stuff, that's like an idea that film students, like, who hijacked a big budget animated movie, and we're like, what if there's drawings on the screen? And the producer's like, whoa, whoa, whoa. And we're like, no, it's gonna be great. So that was like, it was so fun seeing that. Like, that was one of the best days I had is when Lindsay showed us like this weird hybrid scene that she made up, and it was like, it's working. Cause it was so funny to see these like kind of goofy teenage drawings next to this like beautiful rendered CG animation. And then the pacing was just something that we worked out, you know, over the course of the movie. And I think that I'm sort of like a maximalist filmmaker where it's like, throw in everything. And then Chris and Phil are also like that. So we're like, just blend in more and put that in. So that was really fun, but it was also a tricky balance because sometimes people are like, this movie is exhausting. So we would have to like pare it back, and you know, so it was really this process of sort of like pushing and pull and trying to find the sweet spot.
Que tal a gente soltar o celular e fazer 10 segundos de contato visual em família? Começando a... Ah, que coisa mais linda, tão natural.
There's an interview which mentions that the team behind the movie, it's kind of younger compared to other movies, and that there's a lot of new blood now, like people who didn't used to be like in charge. Being in charge. So do you think this kind of new blood helped shape the film better?
Yes. I mean, well, because none of us knew what we weren't supposed to do. And we were like, whatever, we'll do this. And everyone's like, you can't do that. And we're like, we want it. You know, we were brats. But it was all of our first job, and we all had this like crazy, like conspiratorial energy. Like, let's do all the crazy stuff no one ever let us do in our other jobs. You know, because we'd never been in charge before. And it was so cool because like producers are supposed to be like prison wardens, like keeping the artists in check, you know? And like Chris and Phil were like, you know, the guys, Chris Miller and Phil Lord from the Lego movie and Spider-Man and the Spider-Verse, they were like our prison wardens, but they would like, hey, here's the keys, go nuts. You know, like, they're like, riot at 3 p.m. you know, so they were like enabled us to follow our wild sort of ideas and stuff, and they really encouraged it, so, you know, because anytime you do something new, people are like, what are you doing, you know? And they were always like, no, this is cool, like we should support this, and they were like really wonderful.
Atenção, robôs, capturem todas as pessoas no planeta.
While I was preparing for this interview, I read an interview of yours from like 11 years ago.
Okay.
Where you said that, I'm going to quote this.
Okay.
Directing a cartoon movie seems insanely stressful and horrible. So I wanted to know if the actual...
was I, a time traveler? hey, I will say it was... No, I mean, it wasn't horrible, but it was very stressful. It was stressful and it could be really hard. And it was like, there were, you know, nights where I was like, you know, sobbing into my wife's arms like, what's happening? But I will also say there were just as many times where, you know, me and Jeff, my co-director, like high-fiving, like, we're doing it, you know? So it was like a real roller coaster. And the thing that made it work and the thing that made it great was having this awesome team. Like the team around us, you know, like all these first time people are going to be people that you'll hear from for years because they're awesome. And we were so lucky to have them. And people are like, you know, you don't know how lucky you are. And maybe I do. But so it was really like all that inspiration of people trying new things and, hey, what about this idea? Like that really fed you and sort of like and made it all not horrible.
Cool. Glad to see you change your mind.
Yes.
There's a specific scene that I would like to talk about, which is the Furby scene.
Let's do
so
it.
So that was very scary. So did you have any trauma, any previous trauma with them, because you know you traumatized me.
No, I mean I that was always my note. I was like, ooh, it's gotta be scarier. because I don't know, it's like I had a Furby growing up and I loved it, but treating something that looks so goofy with the stakes of like, this is the dragon in Mordor, this is Sauron, you know, the Dark Lord or whatever, I really think like made it funnier. And hopefully that won't freak people out too much. The first test screening we had when we showed the Furby scene, like I would say like 50% of the audience loving it, like laughing, howling. And then I saw one mom just be like, this is enough. And she takes her kids and they walk.
Really? Oh no.
So it was, it's polarizing. But people who like it, I think, really like it.
Nós somos as últimas pessoas. Nós vamos ter que salvar o mundo.
Kate, a gente vai conseguir. Junto.
Família Mitchell no 3.
Família Mitchell.
Pai, sim, no 3. Tem que contar até 3.
1. Família Mitchell.